If the second thing doesn't work, well, so be it. I think making the changes, getting mechanically better players in Wisdom and Sunstar, I think is good, even though Sunstar is an AD carry I wasn't too impressed with back in Korea.
Yeah.
I think Wisdom had some okay games, especially on Gragas last year for the Koo Tigers. If people remember him, he was subbing in a few times for Hojin.
Yeah.
He was underperforming a bit, and then Wisdom played, especially in the Summer Split. Didn't play any games at Worlds, though. He was just there as a sub.
Maybe under the shadow a little bit of that lineup, but now we have the bans coming through. That's an Azir ban going towards Pepe. That's an interesting one.
Interesting, yeah.
Yeah, two jungle bans. Nidalee, Elise makes a lot of sense. Lulu as well, very commonly found on the ban list.
Yeah, now we have 6.4 this week. Obviously, Korea's been playing it. Challenger played 6.4 as well. Quite some changes. A lot of nerfs,
yep.
Honestly, in this patch here. A lot of the standard picks like Fiora and Gangplank and Ezreal has been nerfed a little bit. Not enough, I feel, to kill any of them. I think Gangplank definitely will fall down in priority, and only the hardcore Gangplank players will still use him. But he is still an option. This bad boy is, of course, also an option. We saw SKT valued very highly at IEM. Fnatic picked it up and put in mid lane for Febiven whenever possible.
Yeah, we saw some very cool adaptations as well from Corki into like assassin matchups. Now that Zed's coming back into the mid lane, going for like grass. But we'll talk about that if Pepe decides to pick up Zed, but we'll see. Yeah, Kalista was the final ban out there by a Giants, and now looking towards their first two pickups. We saw Graves a bunch in the top lane. In the jungle, we saw it from.
Yeah, I want to see Nautilus here, Pulse. Because I know he's your favorite champion, or used to be.
It still is.
I think he's such a good top lane pick right now. And also for Gamsu, it was like his main pick together with the Rammus,
yeah.
But the Nautilus was like number one priority. I think Smitty J, he takes it here, and you just deny it. Even with Trundle, I think you can pick Nautilus into it, and you actually have a better laning phase as Nautilus because you can outrange the Trundle.
Yep.
It's just like full late game. Yes, the split pushing is better for Trundle, but then you should have been team fighting already with Corki, with Nautilus, so risky start, I feel, for Giants with it, with the Trundle pick. I like Gragas, though. Mm. Always a safe option with Nidalee's banned. Lee Sin is probably going to be the pick for Spirit with Elise gone, Nidalee gone, Gragas gone. And I like when this guy plays Lee Sin because he can make the big plays.
I mean, he turned up at IEM. He was making a highlight reel all day. He was landing Qs that I was like, that shouldn't hit. Like, how are you curving it around the minions? That makes no sense. But yeah, crazy play from Spirit. Trundle as well is being picked up. Macy in support. May even see a top lane.
Yeah.
China showed us that it's a really good pick in the top lane. I personally feel there's more natural predators in the top lane to Trundle in Europe. The likes of a Graves, for example, that actually beat him out heavily. Norcus as well, high prevalence. But we'll have to see as we get into this, the rest of the picks and bans. We do have Rammus locked in for sure, though.
Okay, very interesting they pick Rammus because he's, like, out of the top lane tanks, one of the top lanes who struggled the most against the Trundle.
Yeah.
Also, just early on in the laning phase, I would have preferred Nautilus specifically, but when you are against a new team with very poor communication, give me a Rammus home guard TP flying around the map, and it will be super difficult for Giants to deal with. So I feel like this is more a pick specifically against Giants than, oh, we prefer Rammus over Nautilus in a normal situation. So I think this is, again, you're expecting a bit of a solo queue game in many ways. Mechanical outplays is going to be what Giants are looking for. It's hard to mechanically outplay a Rammus. He's going to fly in your face with home guards, and he's going to press taunt on you, and that's about it.
True, you can maybe walk behind the minions or do something funky. If you have like pets, for example, you can place them up in front of the Rammus and he bumps the Voidling or whatever instead. That can be really annoying. But we had Fiora picked up, as you mentioned, 6-4. Had slight hits to her W on the cooldown and E on the cooldown. W is now up to like 25 seconds, so it is actually a significant nerf. But it hasn't stopped her from trading at you level 6, and her duelist potential is still good the later you get into the game. So really not going to be seeing a big fall off.
And we see something we have seen more and more in other regions, the Trundle support becoming a bigger thing again. Main reason is simply we have all these tanks in the top lane and Trundle support will still take away your stats. He will become difficult to kill in fights, and he obviously makes these tanks a lot easier to take down. So that's why Giants can run it. It's a very, very weak lane though, Ezreal Trundle. You're not really looking to do anything else other than farming. And also Fiora into Rammus. It's an interesting one because Rammus would go early like Sunfire, Thornmail, and Fiora really heavily needs some lifesteal then to kind of out-sustain him.
Yeah.
But you need items. This is a Smitty J champion though. He is a carry top laner. That's his style. Yeah, he's going to have to perform.
Used to play a lot of Riven, that type of stuff. Riven's kind of dead now, as we saw yesterday as Kaze picked it up.
But RIP.
Yeah, Fnatic just picked up Jhin, which made a lot of people happy in the crowd, including me. Picked up at IEM and did incredibly well.
Are you in the crowd?
Pick. I am. I can actually just jump down there if you want, and you can take this one by yourself. But yeah, Lee Sin was also picked up from Spirit.
What a surprise!
So, I know, crazy. We were talking about it earlier on, and again, just going back to the formula that worked last week, and why not?
Yeah, I mean, very, very, very good pick and ban phase for Fnatic. Basically an IEM pick and ban phase.
Yeah.
Braum is the only new one for Fnatic specifically. A lot of the teams put so much priority on Braum. He's so good in team fights right now. Especially against the likes of an Ezreal. Oh, you want to ulti? Block, you know. Oh, you want to hit a skill shot? Block. You don't really do that much damage as an Ezreal against the Braum in fight. So I like the pickup here from Klaj. I don't know about Viktor Pulse. He's even been nerfed now. He lost some damage on his E here. So yep. Wave play is even a little bit weaker for him. Actually, believe I remember 100% correct, like level 9, he no longer fully clears the backline wave.
He survives with a little bit of health now,
just
yeah.
a little bit of HP. That's the numbers been removed for him. I didn't expect to see much Viktor. He used to be one of the safe picks into Corki, but you will get pushed into your tower and you don't really have much pressure. Giants are packing a little bit too much scaling for my liking. Blue build Ezreal, Viktor mid lane, even Fiora who wants to get two or three items before she really starts taking over that lane. And then a Gragas as well. So like everything is basically scaling for Giants.
Yeah.
And they have been struggling in the early game, and now with new players, less communication.
That's what I was expecting too.
I wanted
like a fast early
yes.
composition to see if they could just mechanically outplay Fnatic and just try and win the game in like 20, 25 minutes,
they look
that type
alike.
Of thing. They do actually, yeah, already got that synergy going down. But on the opposite side, you have like Lee Sin, Corki going to hit spikes in the mid game, Jhin, lane bully. Like, you're going to have this game getting super fast. But jump on Twitter, use the hashtags, hashtag FNC win, hashtag ROC, not ROC win, hashtag GIA win. I got baited there a little right next to Giants, but... yeah, we'll be getting into this game very shortly, but this will be an uphill struggle for the Giants for sure in this game. Not only dealing with communication issues, but also dealing with this composition.
And we're going to have a weird graphic with like three times hashtag different teams winning.
Mm.
People will vote for hashtag ROC win now.
Yeah, it's true.
Guaranteed.
That will skew the next
Guaranteed.
Game as well. And the next game will be Giants. And it's just like, well, it's too late now, guys. You
Let's
had
see,
your
though. Let's see what happens in game, because Giants, risky pick and ban face.
Yeah. All right, let's get into this one's official. Onto the Rift. Giants up against Fnatic. There we can see the Owl that we were talking about, not only in IM, but Challenger. We had a vote. Unzo Owl versus Kevin Owl. Those are two observers here today. And I believe Kevin Owl did win by 54%. So now, ladies and gentlemen, that is Kevin the Owl on Summoner's Rift. There we go. That's some hype for the Owl, man.
I'm sure it's for the Owl.
Yeah, all 100%. The Owl.
So, Fnatic back from IEM. You play SKT, and then the next week you play Giants.
Mm.
Change, obviously, for them. Also, BO1. You play BO5 and yeah. BO3s
well,
at IEM
see
a lot.
The Koreans come in, it's like, I've dealt with your kind before. I took down Faker. I know what to do in this situation.
Yeah, and then Wisdom Sunstar. Not quite Faker level. Mm. I think that's fair to say. I still do think Wisdom is a fine jungler. He had some pretty good games, but again, mainly on Gragas when he played for the Koo Tigers last year. Still, Fnatic is basically drafted exactly the same they drafted at IEM. It is, as you said, early game focus, strong laning. Corki can constantly push his lane. Jhin is a fantastic laning AD carry, definitely beats out an Ezreal. Add in a Braum, by the way, to proc the passive on a melee support. Ooh, scary, scary stuff. And you can see Giants tried to lane swap. Fnatic just managed to guess it. Often what happens, like, I think there's a high percent chance if there's no invade and the enemy team has a weaker 2v2, just go top yourself. Mm-hmm. Obviously, yeah, they can bait you and still go bot lane, but I think there's a high chance they will swap to top.
Oh no, oh, the darkest timeline. Spirit walks into the jungle of Giants at level 2, just takes away the Murkwolf. He just read the jungle pattern perfectly from Wisdom.
And again, this is what we talk about when you have these lanes getting pushed in. Look at Pepe. He's already behind his tower, basically. Because Febiven has just pushed him all the way in. The wave is just reset. And now Pepe trying to push it back out. So again, you can easily invade.
Yep.
When your mid lane is pushing, top laner goes even at this point. And you're playing Lee Sin into Gragas. Just invade in, take away stuff. He doesn't have any kill pressure on you. And again, this is the Fnatic style. Strong early game, invading jungler. This is the style Spirit likes to play. And I'm so happy that over these 13 games Fnatic played at IEM, they really found the correct pick and ban phase for their players. And Gamsu, he gets a lot of early ganks now. Here comes another one.
Definitely seems to be coming together. Spirit's catching up, lands the Q, the resonating strike. Bit of a riposte that reflects some of the damage onto Spirit as he takes the minion damage as well, but he'll most likely be helping Gamsu push this into turret, bounce it. Maybe little Rammus will go back to base and pick up some items.
Oh,
also,
yeah.
We saw the Keystone Masteries come out. Rekkles running Deathfire Touch. We're often seeing some Jhins pick that up versus, like, for example, different ones like
Warlords.
Warlords is the other main one for the
Warlords
crit and the heal.
Was the one when it used to rely on the crit.
Yeah.
Because you get the guaranteed crit for Jhin, but here on 6.4, Warlords has now been changed. It's now giving lifesteals based on Olaf passive as a keystone. So that obviously doesn't have much value for Jhin anymore. You're not standing and kind of trying to lifesteal your way back up at 20% HP with your four quick attacks, and that's it. Therefore, Deathfire Touch is better.
You get so much AD for that for scale off.
Yeah, it's quite disgusting.
Yeah.
I mean, Jhin, for people who still 100% don't know too much about Jhin, his AD late game, because he gains AD obviously from getting crit and so on, he reaches like 700 plus AD, full late game, full build. It is quite insane to look at. And then he can just deal so much damage, especially with his ulti. The fourth hit that is a guaranteed crit on his ulti. I mean, you can crit for like 1,500 to 2,000 basically
in
late game.
We were looking at the numbers before and it's like, this is actually insane. That will chunk someone down like a squishy to the point where they just like walk out of base, get hit by fourth gen ultimate shot, and it's like, I'm going back. Top lane, this is still Australia lane, so Sunstar and Godfred trying to farm away in the top lane. Fairly even CS though. So not falling too far behind. Most of the lanes are fairly even, but definitely does seem that Fnatic have a slight advantage in terms of lane pressure, which is difficult to quantify in terms of numbers, but they're straight up pushing Giants in the top lane, mid lane, bot lane's being stalled out, and Fiora can't really bully a Rammus.
And something we often talk about as well, with these wave clear picks in mid lane, Braum just counters so many of them, because the wave clear you do have as a Viktor, your laser, Braum shield will block it.
Mm-hmm.
You don't kill the wave all of a sudden. Ezreal wants to ulti the wave. Braum shield will block it. You don't clear that wave either. So Giants again are packing this super late game scaling, wave clear, you know, just try and farm up for the first 25 minutes. But so many things from Fnatic can break it. Lee Sin and Rammus as well, fantastic at even diving on the turrets if a single member is standing there trying to defend and wave clear. There's very little you can do. Obviously, xPePii is running Clint because he's against Rammus, so that's a good choice. But then what do you do against the Lee Sin? When he flies in, he kick flashes you and you're back and you're dead anyway. And then Braum just stands in front of the wave. So it's very difficult for Giants to sustain or to defend, I guess you should say. xPePii will use his ulti, just try and shove xPePii back.
It's not going to be a kill because xPePii was out of mana after making that play. It would just be a defensive Valkyrie. And Spirit's there. The flash from Gamsu should be able to lock him down here. Here comes the flash away, but Spirit, he still had his Q. That's going to be quickly riposted. Now under this tower, Spirit will have to flash away. Nice outplay by Smitty.
Yeah, really like the play from Smitty here, saving the riposte. And Wisdom is here for backup in case Fnatic goes aggressive.
Spirit's here. Now they're both under the tower. Spirit will jump away to the back line of minions. Gamsu just get a nice taunt out, but Spirit does not really want to go in on that. His mind and body are both telling him, no, don't click that Q.
Super well played by Smitty, though. Also having the grasp with the Undying ready to get that one hit, get a bit of lifesteal back. Therefore forcing Spirit to flash away. Wisdom can now be a little bit aggressive, clear out a pink ward. That's the part of being aggressive. And Gamsu wants to get him, but just dash over the wall. Yep, Dragon says hello, wakes up. And then you can kill the Rift Scuttler, because why not?
Yeah. You have to get the CC down on that one, so we're going to see that play in bottom lane once again in this lead-up.
So again, this is what you can do with Rammus in melee matchups. It's so easy just to taunt, obviously, these targets and then set up the gank, but he's saving his riposte now, gets the first Q, and he waits now for Spirit to proc the second one, riposte the damage, and then gets the heal from his grasp of the Undying, and now Spirit has nothing left to use because he's not level 6 yet. Doing the replay, he is now for the next gank. Therefore, Smitty J survives. And now, here's the return gank. You have no flash. against the Rammus with Taunt, and now Spirit is level 6.
It's hard for Gamsu to get in range, though. Last time he managed to flash bump.
The timing is good, though. Look at the wave
look
pushing.
Look at the minion wave. Here comes Spirit, kick immediately against the wall, right into the Taunt. He's immediately locked down, and he uses riposte as soon as he can. Spirit, he's going to have to land the Q here if he wants to pick up the kill. There is no riposte this time around. It's all on this, but the lunge away. And once again, Smitty gets away from this gank, and the pressure from Spirit and Gamsu, a lot of time lost.
I dislike almost everything about the way Fnatic were executing that gank. I don't think there's any reason for Spirit to walk in there and try and kick Smitty J sideways into a taunt of Gamsu. Just let Gamsu run at him with Powerball.
Oh man, here we go. Onto Poppy. The package has been delivered. And this is a cut and dry kill. One on one. Febiven has taken down the Demon King, and they'll do the same to Pepe.
Pepe was staying in lane, trying to push it out to get enough gold to go back and upgrade his Hex Core. You can see with the items here, he's just getting upgraded now. I just had to drink for some reason while I have actually no idea why.
I was like, you want me to follow on with this point this year? Like,
Paper was like, I just need to push one more wave, get it into tower, deny a little bit of CS. Not realizing we're 8 minutes into the game. Package arrives, even gets a warning sound and a sound and everything. He's like, yeah, one more wave. And Febiven flies in, kills you. And that's, it's one of these sloppy deaths we just don't like seeing. Because, yes, okay, you want to show out that wave, but you had cleared enough for Pink and a Biscuit anyway. So was it really worth it? Couldn't you just gone back, waited for 1,000 gold, upgrade your item, return to lane and not die?
One more wave is the bane of laners absolutely everywhere. Rekkles should be able to get a lot of these minions under tower, and Klaj will set him up as well. Got that synergy. Mid lane tower also went down from the play from Febiven onto Pepe. This is a significant CS lead. Bot lane is going to be taunting up Smitty. Gamsu's popping the ultimate to push out the wave and deal some extra damage. That's the problem with Rammus as well in 1v1 matchups. Rammus, he almost always has Tremors since it has an incredibly short cooldown, even at early ranks. Mm-hmm. So if you want to go for a trade with him, you're going to be eating a lot of the damage from Tremors. And because it lasts for such a long time, like prolonged trade, you're going to lose.
Spirit mid lane now, though. Pepe has no summoners.
Febiven has already Valkyried, but Spirit landing the Q means this is another cut and dry kill. It's, I mean, this is just Pepe going too far up.
Yeah, the rest of Giants have honestly been playing well. Even laning 2v2 on top here from Sunstar and Godfred, Spirit is going to find Wisdom, or maybe Wisdom finds Spirit.
We're about to find out. Oh, I believe Wisdom found Spirit there.
Good.
Spirit had to use his ultimate. But Sunstar and Godfred go back to top lane, and you're just talking about them. Yeah, they're basically going even the laners. Smitty J has had an enormous amount of gank pressure on him and still not died.
Right, he's still even in his lane. Sadly, it is on the old star player, Pepe. He's the guy now letting down his team, first overstaying, dying to Febiven, then having no summoners, obviously return gank from Spirit, and suddenly 2-0 Fnatic, and always build around Febiven in this mid. Once you have mid lane pressure, you can start putting pressure on side lanes. That's what exactly what they're doing now, setting up a potential dive on Smitty.
Well, Gamsu may even drop here. Smitty has one option, that's to try and kill Gamsu before he goes down himself. He forces that flash from Gamsu. Not quite got the confidence in his team that he could burst them, burst Smitty down before he went down himself.
And this again is one of the issues when you have a mid laner like Viktor, especially when he starts falling behind, it's even worse. But he can't roam. He's stuck mid lane just wavefling, and it's a bit old school because almost all the mid laners in the current meta are good at pushing out a lane and then moving to side lanes, you know. Or you run teleport and you can TP to a side lane. So you can always put pressure on other lanes. This is exactly what Febiven and Spirit are doing here. Because they have already been winning mid. Go bot lane. Ganking Smitty with two didn't work. Add in another one, you know. Put in Febiven here. Strong 3-0 Corki. Independent Corki. And then you pick up the kill.
If Smitty had gotten one more auto attack off, that would have proc'd the ultimate, so that bit of healing may not have saved him, but a lot of the big burst abilities have been used from Fnatic, so maybe he would have gotten out alive, but either way, it was all down to that auto attack, and that did not ultimately happen in this game. Top lane, there's been a whole lot of farming going on in this lane. There's been pressure for sure by Klaj and Rekkles, and I always see them at this point in lane where they're kind of pushing them away, but Sunstar has been picking up most of the minions when it's been hitting tower, and with another minion wave coming in, it's just going to be even in a couple seconds.
I mean, I think Trundle Ezreal is one of the easiest combos, or actually easiest combos to farm on a tower with. Let's talk about after, because Wisdom.
Nice flash kick coming in from the Spirit.
Still alive.
He have the damage. Wisdom uses the ultimate. Pepe perhaps called out. He comes in with the sidestep. Big crit from Febiven. Will pick up the first kill. Smitty tries to help his allies, but another big crit comes out. Spirit's coming in. That's the Q. Ultimate grand challenge issued. Pepe will rise to the challenge, but he'll be taken out by a Fossbomb on the return kill from Febiven. A 3-4-1 in Fnatic's favor.
And it's the same again for Fnatic. Everything is built around Spirit and Febiven moving from their lane, taking fights. They're basically saying we're fine trading farm and top lane. You know, AD carry support, you can stand there and have your little party. We don't care. Because against this Viktor, we are way stronger with the Lee Sin as well. 5 kills for Febiven already. Like, engage onto Wisdom. You can see both top laners are coming from their lane now. So this is just a 2v2. But Pepe is too weak to really take anyone down, and Wisdom is forced to play very defensive because he got chunked at first. Makes it very easy for Fnatic to stay and win this fight. And just wait also for Gamsu to show up, and 1 kill for Giants. Currently 5 kills for Febiven.
Yeah.
We are 13 minutes in on this Corki here. I know he has a big mid-game power spike. Give him 5 kills.
I mean, it's 13 minutes into the game. He has Triforce BF Sword. Like, he was landing some dirty crits on that last fight. Like, they were chunking people for like a third of their health.
He's buying pinks now.
What a team player.
The no pinks, no drinks that Daylor and Force doing IEM is working.
I remember you saying that.
Technically, it was Twitch chat who said it.
Yeah.
Then Krepo and me, we kind of stole it.
Oh, okay.
But it's what we do.
It's yours now. Copyright it. Ship it. Deficio 2016 IEM. Bot lane, Smitty J, he's pushing up a little here, but because there's no tower anymore, or soon there will be no tower anymore. Because
I feel bad for Smitty J. Honestly, he played this lane pretty well.
Yeah.
But his own jungler never showed at all. And I think Gragas at level 6 should be able to have ganking pressure.
At least counter gank.
The problem is, again, when your mid lane is getting pushed in, as a jungler moving into river and setting up a potential gank is super difficult. Because there's such a high chance the enemy jungler is going to find you, and then this 2v2 around mid and river, you're going to lose it. So, even if you fight, by the way, in the bottom side, the mid laner can just move first. So Febiven will always move first. That means you can't really take the trades. So you always have to like have weird ganking paths as a jungler if your lanes are falling behind, where you're like trying to sneak behind them over the wall and like flash body slam and knock them back. So it made it very difficult for Wisdom. Which meant Smitty J has been all alone, honestly, on the bottom side for almost the entire game. And just look at Fnatic now, and look at the Fnatic we saw 3 weeks ago, trying to play 40-minute scaling comps, like, let's protect Rekkles as the only thing we do. That style? Garbage. This style? Fantastic.
Pepe is getting blown by Febiven in the mid lane. Spirit comes in as well, tries to pick up the kill. And now Smitty J coming in from the bot side, trying to get something done in the mid lane, but I think he just really has to take the long route back to his base. But yeah, talking about Fnatic's style, like, Fnatic have definitely been, just gonna hold that thought for a second. Gamsu has sniffed out Smitty J as he's trying to contest those Merc walls. But yeah, Fnatic have definitely been on the uptrend when it's come to their style, because yeah, you kind of hit it there. 3 weeks ago was when they really started changing their style, heading into IEM. Like, for example, Spirit, 5 out of his last 6 games have been on Lee Sin. So they definitely have been looking towards this style and what works for them. And I mean, why not keep doing it? Like, it's
sure.
The only thing the analysts were saying was potentially they have small champion pulls that could be target banned away, like take away the Lee Sin, you put them on a different early pressure jungler instead. Does it change the dynamic of Fnatic at all? That's a potential question, but it's not like we're just seeing Gamsu on Nautilus again and then Spirit on Lee Sin. Like, we're seeing other picks as well come out from Fnatic. Like,
yeah,
Braum, for example.
Right, this is what we talk about, the ganks coming in from way behind. It's just very easy to ward against them when you've been winning, because you can get a few wards in the enemy jungle and you can spot that Gragas. But again, also for Fnatic, and just from talking to Febiven before the game, he was basically saying, we got to play 13 games at IEM. It was so much practice for us, and just almost every single game we felt like we learned something new. And we were, and now they were trying this new style with more early game aggression. Well, you got to play that for 13 games.
Yeah.
You played 14 games in the LCS coming into IEM. So obviously they've never been getting twice the amount of practice as most of the other teams, playing on stage, playing new comps. And because it worked, because they made the final, obviously you're gonna stick to this comp and you're gonna look at it and say, oh, a lot of things here are going well. Few issues maybe here and there. Let's work on fixing them. I like Klaj on a Braum pick. Not that we have seen him in this game at all because he's just been laning.
Yeah.
But I think on Braum, he won't overextend as much as he likes to do on a thresh.
Oh man, I mean,
we have seen it before. but as he likes to do on thresh, you know, where he stands in the front trying to make the big play. I think on Braum, he's more going to focus on actually protecting his backline, which I think suits him quite a lot. He did play it at IEM a few times. I just want to see more and more and more, because I think Braum is such a good pick. And of course, Braum is the reason Fnatic is winning in 7-1 in this game. I mean, you can see it, 0-0-0, 19 CS.
Unbelievable pick. But yeah, do you start like sandbagging in IEM just to get more games? Because the problem with SKT is they arrived and played like, you know, 4 20-minute games.
Well, you still kind of need to win the games to get more games.
Sure, but you lose like a game, so you keep the series alive and then you keep going for a little bit.
I guess technically, yeah.
Yeah.
Jokes on SKT for not doing that, playing the lowest amount of games possible.
And short games as well.
Yeah.
Fnatic even denied them from more game time in the last game.
Fnatic is playing playing for worlds now.
Yeah.
You know, more games than IEM, meaning they have a better chance of beating SKT at worlds. It's basically what we're saying.
I see. Start early, get the ball rolling. Top lane is definitely being a farm fest, but overall Rekkles has managed to get ahead very slightly in terms of that CS.
This is one of these games where as an AD carry, you just tunnel vision on farming.
Yeah.
You don't actually know what's happening on the map. You just keep pressing tab to see if you're winning farm. And randomly, you just start noticing your team is just getting further and further ahead and just taking towers in the enemy territory and like warding up enemy jungles, stealing dragons. And you're just farming.
It's time for double kill.
Well, I'm sure Rekkles and Klaj is having a super fun game.
Yeah.
Same for Godfred and Sunstar.
Rekkles is already on Infinity Edge, looking towards the Static Shift now as well. He's going to be an extremely frightening Jhin. Because no one on Giants really, apart from Sunstar and Godfred, have even seen Rekkles in this game, when you get to like these skirmishes and teamfights, Pepe's going to be like, what even is this damage? Like, it just comes out of nowhere and gets two-shot.
And that's the thing about Jhin. If you can land skill shots, oh my god, he's he's fantastic. We don't even show SmithyJ dying anymore, because he's just getting ganked again by Spirit, and he's just left alone completely. But Giants are just so far back on the map.
But like, let's talk about where this came from, though, because Spinny was fine. Like, he was defending ganks that, like, okay, there was some misplays by Spirit and Gamsu in that, but SmithyJ played really well on the turret, for example. But mid lane collapsed. Like, xPePii died 1-on-1, lost his tower, lost mid pressure because of that tower. Then Febiven just started going to side lanes. He's 6-0-1 because he's been just killing everyone on the map. And we were looking at, like, these new imports. Maybe are they going to start being the problem? But it actually came from xPePii.
I think we talked about it if we go back to champ select. Why I don't like Viktor right now as a pick. Not only has he been nerfed on 6.4, he can't push out the lane against the likes of a Corki in the early game. He can't roam from his lane either. He's stuck just farming.
Yeah.
Viktor is fine if you go to 3 items. The problem is you need to make sure the team around you are basically winning on their own, because you're not helping. I just don't think he's a good pick, because I think the current meta is so focused around almost a win lane, win game kind of mentality, which is why Fnatic's pick and ban phase fit the meta so well. Because you want strong laners and a strong early game jungler. Gragas even counts there because he gets level 6 and he's actually really, really strong and he can start really becoming annoying to deal with. And you just start playing super aggressive in lanes, push them up, set up invades with your own jungler, set up deep vision, set up tower dives. And Giants are just playing pure scaling on like everything.
Yeah. Victor's always a pick now. It's just like, what else do we have to pick? Oh, nothing. Oh, maybe find Klaj though, setting up this play for a while. How's he get knocked back? Was that Gragas ult? Wisdom literally just knocked back Klaj. Oh, because the Unbreakable was up, because it blocked the projectile, so Klaj got knocked back instead of being knocked into the team, because Wisdom was trying to knock him in. I think the Unbreakable came up. I'm gonna double check. Yep, there it is.
Yep, I like how Klaj joins the game. They're like, anyone in here? Oh, yep, okay.
Yep.
Don't worry, I'm alive. He even has Summoners.
That is actually a really annoying interaction for Gragas into Braum. As soon as the Unbreakable comes up, anyone who's standing behind Klaj's shield will just be knocked away from the Gragas.
And we have the classic Rammus split push.
Yeah, against Fiora.
Not very classic, but
like,
when you go Thornmail Sunfire and you are winning your lane because your jungler is obviously camping the lane over and over, you become basically unkillable for the Fiora. Smitty is trying to get his life steal build up here. He's just so far behind. That's the last
Gamsu's
out of turret.
Ready.
Well, what is he going to TP to?
They
don't want to set up Baron already. Just recall, use all your gold. Let's see how much gold they have. 1500 for Febiven, 1500 Rekkles. Spend it, go back in, take Dragon, set up a Baron, have your Rammus ready to TP in with Home Guard, and just take that one team fight that technically should close out the game. Because Giants are so far behind and they're not ready to fight. Don't even understand the build for KP with Lich Bane.
Now he's getting Lich Bane here. So
that's not very good at all. Like, you just want more raw AP at this point.
All right, time to swap out Smitty with Pepe and go up against the Rammus. And Rammus won't be able to run away from Victor's auto attack. So they're playing the long game. I don't know, it's a little
bit Lich Bane just doesn't have any value at all.
Gives you a bit of extra movement speed. All I want from this game is I want Rekkles to hit someone. Like, all I've seen him do this game is hit minions. I just want him to hit a champion and see how much damage it does.
I want one of those games where AD carry does like 400 damage only. He hit him with W. He got an assist.
Okay, well...
Fnatic bot line. Bot line. Bot lane. They're online.
They're online.
It's called the bot line.
Yeah. They are in the game, on the board. 0-0-1. And now they're on the Baron. And this will be going down fairly quickly. There's some big crits coming out from Jhin. Godfred, Pepe, and Sunstar are going to try and maybe contest, but Klaj is right there. He might go down. Yeah. He eats all of it so that they can secure the Baron Nashor. Now 4v4 before Smitty joins. Here comes the ultimate, the curtain call.
And a crit.
That was quite unimpressive.
Well, problem is you need Tiger to be low to get the extra
and it was
percent damage. Off.
I'm a bit disappointed. There was a lot of build-up to that play.
Yeah. I was about to say perfect game for Giants, but already got a kill before anyway, so... Doesn't matter. No towers, though. Base is open. Baron has been taken. Oh!
Wisdom coming in for this engage here. Rekkles, nice knockback. Gamsu, he's in the fight! Goes on to Sunstar with the Powerball. He'll have to jump away there. Spirit, meanwhile, taking out Wisdom. Speedy J being chunked down. He's being exhausted. And Spirit wants kills. Flash kick immediately off the back of the kill. Into a kill onto Godfred. As smooth as you like. And now going on to the Nexus turrets itself. Meanwhile, Sunstar trying to make something happen. But the crit from Febiven will finish him up. Pad those fancy score lines. Gamsu is going to try and stay alive here, but Fnatic, a convincing win in around 25 minutes up against Giants, takes them down.
Yeah, honestly, there wasn't really much to talk about here. I don't often think a game can be decided in the pick and ban phase, but I think you can gain a massive advantage in the pick and ban phase. And I think Fnatic in this game came very close to honestly just straight up winning it before the game even started. Because I think Fnatic drafted what I like to see in this meta here, again, strong laners, early game jungler. It's all about pushing in your lanes and then be able to apply pressure on other lanes at the same time and set up ganks for... No sound effects though, just a bit of music coming over.
I was expecting you to do the sound effects.
Yeah, I was thinking, you know, should I do it? I'm like, nah, not really. I was gonna do the H2 and then like it doesn't really fit in. But again, this comp from Fnatic, just, it's what the teams showed at IEM. It's what's super strong right now. And I think Giants just completely drafted the opposite. Because when every lane is gonna struggle,